You are a factory of sadness! 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 Sadness!
Last time we saw Mike, we said, take a week off. It's bye week. What could possibly happen? Well, that was our first mistake.
It was. And then after yesterday, Manziel News, we just had to call him in for a special edition of Brown's Hangover. Take it away, Mike, because I know you have a lot to say.
You guys are ruining my reputation as a gentleman of leisure who barely works. You're making me come in on my off week. But thanks, Johnny. Well, Cleveland, it pains me to say this, and I don't want to seem like a Debbie Downer, but I do think it's time we all admit to ourselves that it might not have been such a great idea for our struggling football team to use a first-round draft pick on a spoiled 5'9" quarterback with a history of alcohol and behavioral issues. Who possibly could have foreseen that ending poorly, with the exception of all 31 other NFL teams who wouldn't have touched Manziel with a 10-foot pole prior to round 5? But who's counting? In case you haven't seen it, take a look at the latest entry from the long-running Johnny Manziel Drunk in a Bar International Film Festival. This is obviously a bummer for all the Browns fans, but it's especially hard on Johnny's unwavering meathead brother fan base. The pungent smell of Axe body spray mixed with tears permeated the Cleveland air last night as dudes in weight rooms and BW3s across the greater Cleveland mourned the latest benching of their tiny drunken spirit animal. I'd like to address Mr. Manziel directly for a moment now. So Johnny, if you're seeing this, please ask the bartender if she'll turn down the jukebox for a minute so you can hear me. First of all, I want to make this clear. This is not all your fault. You are a self-destructive person working in a terrible and dysfunctional workplace. It's common knowledge that finding a stable and safe environment in which to recover following rehab is crucial to maintaining sobriety. Can you think of a less stable environment than the Cleveland Browns organization? Working here cannot be healthy for you, given your demons. It would be like if a drug addict came out of rehab and immediately took a job working as a tour roadie for the Grateful Dead. Not a great idea. That said, Johnny, you're still behaving like a jerk. And honestly, I think we'd all be okay with it if you had actually earned the right to be a jerk. But you haven't done anything yet. Dez Bryant, the Dallas receiver, is a huge jerk, but he's also a 2-time Pro Bowler, so it's worth putting up with him. If you managed to get 9 wins in a season for the Browns, we wouldn't care if you showed up 5 minutes before each game riding a jet ski up the Cuyahoga River, holding a bottle of Kettle One with Rihanna hanging onto your back. But you don't get that right to act like a monster until you actually do something for us. Here's a simple piece of advice, Johnny. Stop letting people record you when you're at the bar. When you're partying and you see someone film you with their phone, you don't have to dash towards the camera like a moth to a flame. Say to the person, hey, I'd rather not be on camera right now. It seems like that very rarely ends well for me. Of course, Johnny, your avid supporters are all over social media with the same old pathetic arguments, such as, what's the big deal? It was during his free time and he wasn't doing anything illegal. Sure, technically that's true. But it's also totally legal to drive to your boss's house on the weekend, knock on the door, and tell him his wife is ugly. That's perfectly legal, but it doesn't mean that there aren't going to be some ramifications in the workplace on Monday. He's just a kid. He's 22 years old. I used to party like that when I was 22. Yeah, but you're a house painter. No one cares what you do. I used to party like that when I was 22, when I was a landscaper. I wasn't making millions of dollars, though, and being given the opportunity to lead an NFL team. The worst-case scenario, if I came into my job as a landscaper hungover when I was 22, was that the smell of the mulch I was spreading might make me nauseous and I'd throw up on some lady's flower bed. Nobody gets hurt. In fact, it's probably good for the perennials. Fair or not, the stakes are a little higher for Johnny than they were for us at that age. In closing, Johnny, it's still never been made public exactly what you went to rehab for this past summer. But let's assume that you were there for exhaustion and you don't have a legitimate drinking problem. You just like to party. Can't you wait a little bit, Johnny? According to the NFL and their Players Association, the average NFL career lasts between 3 to 6 years. The current average American lifespan for males is 77 years. That means that if you played for 6 productive, sober years, you could retire at 27, rich and respected, and still have 50 full years to ride on inflatable swans, slam Jaeger bombs, and judge wet t-shirt contests until you die. Doesn't that sound nice? Get it together, young man. As always, go Browns, and happy Thanksgiving.
Well, I would think it's safe to say Johnny Manziel will not be sending Mike a Christmas card. What do you think?
Probably not.
Fingers crossed. You never know. Sometimes you need a little tough love.
You know, and hopefully lesson learned. All right. Thanks for coming in tonight,
no problem.
Mike.
Appreciate it, Mike, working overtime.